Prince Harry is given a full head of hair in a new royal biopic, despite having thinning locks in real life. However, his balding brother William is portrayed by an actor who has lost most of his hair. New pictures show American newcomers Jordan Dean and Sidney Morton playing the Duke and Duchess of Sussex in the US TV film Meghan and Harry, Escaping the Palace. The movie reimagines the couple's decision to quit royal life. William is played by US actor Jordan Whalen, while Singapore-born Laura Mitchell takes on the role of Kate. The film, which has been dubbed cheese at its finest, features Harry and Meghan's bombshell interview with Oprah Winfrey. Other scenes include a dream sequence in which Harry has a nightmare that his wife dies in a car crash, like his mother Princess Diana. The film will be seen in the US on Monday and in the UK at a later date. By Hayley Richardson for Mail Online. Prince Harry will take aim at stepmother Camilla Parker, Bowles, and may name the royal racist because his publishers want their money's worth, according to Paul Burrell. The ex-royal butler said the Duke of Sussex is set to reveal any Camilla secrets after the Duchess of Cornwall stepped into Diana's shoes as his father's wife. He added that Prince Charles, 72, would be livid if his son paints her in a bad light in the tell-all, due to be published in 2022 as part of a lucrative four-book deal believed to be worth up to £29 million. Speaking to Closer magazine, Princess Diana's former butler, 63, said, "The publisher, Penguin, will no doubt want their money's worth in this book deal. That means they won't want vagueness, they'll want names and specifics." He added that Harry could very well name the alleged racist within the firm, whom he and Meghan Markle claimed raised concerns about how dark their son Archie's skin might be before he was born during their Oprah Winfrey interview earlier this year. Paul added that he personally doesn't believe there is any racism in the royal family, having never got a hint of anything during his decade working in the palace. He went on to claim Harry will no doubt go into depth about his feelings after his mother's tragic death in the tome, and the subsequent events. Paul suggested Harry may go for Camilla after the reports she was involved in his parents' marriage and then stepped into Diana's shoes as Charles' wife. "I suspect Camilla will be in his sights, so I'd say Harry's set to reveal any Camilla secrets," he told Closer. He's already said he enjoys The Crown, which painted Camilla as the wicked stepmother in a way. "Charles will be livid if he does go there." Harry reportedly did not warn his father about his plan to write an explosive Megxit memoir, which he has been working on for over a year. The Duke has been collaborating with Pulitzer-winning ghostwriter J.R. Moringer in a rare move from a senior member of the royal family. The first draft of the manuscript, currently untitled, is said to be almost completely written and is due to be submitted in October. The proceeds of the deal are likely to be worth millions and, although the exact financial terms were not disclosed, Prince Harry will donate proceeds to charity, according to Random House. Royal experts have questioned Harry's motive for writing the book, pointing out he is already wealthy and has previously spoken at length about Megxit. Royal expert Richard Fitzwilliams told Mail Online Harry was exorcising his demons with the book, but queried how one-sided it would be. Harry previously said, "I'm writing this not as the prince I was born but as the man I have become. I've worn many hats over the years, both literally and figuratively, and my hope is that in telling my story, the highs and lows, the mistakes, the lessons learned, I can help show that no matter where we come from, we have more in common than we think. I'm deeply grateful for the opportunity to share what I've learned over the course of my life so far and excited for people to read a first-hand account of my life that's accurate and wholly truthful." Prince Harry signed up to the book deal despite issuing repeated calls for his family's privacy to be respected. A statement from the publisher about the upcoming book read, "In an intimate and heartfelt memoir from one of the most fascinating and influential global figures of our time, Prince Harry will share, for the very first time, the definitive account of the experiences, adventures, losses, and life lessons that have helped shape him. Covering his lifetime in the public eye from childhood to the present day, including his dedication to service, the military duty that twice took him to the front lines of Afghanistan, and the joy he has found in being a husband and father, Prince Harry will offer an honest and captivating personal portrait, one that shows readers that behind everything they think they know lies an inspiring, courageous and uplifting human story." Marcus Dole, CEO of Penguin Random House, said, All of us at Penguin Random House are thrilled to publish Prince Harry's literary memoir and have him join the world, renowned leaders, icons, and change makers we have been privileged to publish over the years. Prince Harry has harnessed his extraordinary life experience as a prince, a soldier, and a knowledgeable advocate for social issues, establishing himself as a global leader recognized for his courage and openness. It is for that reason we're excited to publish his honest and moving story. Last night, Prince Harry used a live video message from his LA mansion to launch a new assault on the media and lecture on inequality in a surprise speech to VIPs, including Piers Morgan, hours after the ex-GMB host won a thumping victory for free speech over Meghan. Dressed in a black tie and tuxedo, the Duke used his big screen speech beam to the GQ Awards in London to blame those who peddle in lies and fear in the news media and social media for vaccine hesitancy. Watching was Mail Online columnist Piers Morgan, who yesterday won a resounding victory for free speech after regulator Ofcom ruled he had not broken the broadcasting code for his comments on the Duchess of Sussex following her bombshell Oprah interview. This morning he tweeted an image of Harry live from California with the hashtag Orcs, a nod to his free speech win. Harry, who referred to Britain as our nation in his address, delivered a chiding speech urging governments to do more to vaccinate poorer countries, warning until every community can access the vaccine and until every community is connected to trustworthy information about the vaccine, then we are all at risk. Speaking from his Montecito mansion more than 5,000 miles away, the beleaguered prince lectured his star-studded London audience on media misinformation and the importance of sharing vaccines. Harry later presented the Heroes of the Year Award to Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert, Professor Catherine Green and the team behind the Oxford/AstraZeneca vaccine. After being invited onto the stage by Harry, Professor Green told the crowd, "I promised Sarah I wouldn't get too ped, and I promised I wouldn't swear, but there was no faint chance of that because I'm so starstruck." Harry's live speech was at 11 p.m. London time, 3 p.m. LA time, and Mr. Morgan left the venue at around 11:15 p.m., after the Duke had finished and handed out the award.